Hi everybody, Sandy Boucher here, and welcome back to my world, in this case, my living room. This is the last post, the last video I'm going to do before the draw for the talking stick. But I did promise you that I would explain the story in the beadwork. I have to admit, I had so much fun. There was so much joy for me in making this talking stick because anyone who knows me knows I'm a storyteller. That's why I write books. And then writing those books morphed into my seminars and my daily blog posts. But one of the other things I love is beadwork. And in the last three sticks I've done, those two loves have truly come together to the point where I'm now telling stories in my beadwork. And I cannot wait to send this off to its new home. So first, I should explain the story behind the beadwork. So first and foremost, the white part is kind of just life, like air. Right? And every now and then, if you see this yellow blob here, and this is where the journey starts, there's, you know, those happy times that we come upon, you know, something amazing happens, you get a raise at work, or you find out you're going to be a mom or a grandma or a grandpa or whatever the case may be, those happy times. But there's dark times too. And sometimes if I just turn this stick, those dark times can seem overwhelming, where they block out almost everything. But if you keep going, and even more importantly, if you're smart enough to ask for help, well, then you find your path out. And if you watch my fingernail, it'll help you follow along the journey. So here's the path away, breaking away from the dark time and slowly finding its way. It's still dark, but we're finding our way. And then if you noticed, one red bead, a teaching, support from someone, a quote that resonates with you, a life lesson that truly helps you. So you take that and it becomes part of who you are, and you continue down your path and you pick up another teaching. And I'm going to get mad at my cat in a minute. Excuse me, Oreo, shh. I'm trying to talk to the people. Well, anyways, Oreo likes your attention too. So more teachings, and you ingrain them. They become part of who you are, and the journey continues, and you come upon another happy time, but somehow you don't really feel part of it yet. You enjoy it, but that dark time is still there, still ingrained in you, still holding on. So the journey continues and you're constantly adding more teachings and they're becoming part of who you are, and you keep going and you're going. And this time, the next time something amazing and happy happens, you notice you enjoy it more. The yellow part is bigger. You get to enjoy it to a greater extent. And the journey continues. And now all those teachings that you've received, they become part of you. They become your core. And suddenly the dark times are diminishing. And for Indigenous people, we know this as finding the red road, that we start to recognize our core in our teachings and our ceremonies, and the journey continues. And again, this time a happy time hits, but now you're enjoying it way more than you did the other two times. And your journey continues. And then something amazing happens. The happiness starts to come from inside, not outside. True happiness, contentment, acceptance. And you start to feel it inside. It becomes part of you until the dark is gone. And now it's just you and your teachings and your happiness and those bad times. And even the good times are now external, as you realize your happiness has always been inside. Now, when you come to the end here, you notice it's not finished. That's because your journey isn't finished. And neither is either end of the talking stick. At this end is all the teachings and lessons yet to come. And at this end, all the teachings and lessons we can take from those that came before. That is the story of this talking stick. I will be raffling it off at 6 p.m. today, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. This is your last chance to get tickets. EMT them to sandy.boucher@shaw.ca, sandi.boucher@shaw.ca. Share this post, this video with a friend. Did you see Oreo just go by? That was so cute. Share this post, this video with friends. Make sure they get tickets if they want. I can't wait to find out who this stick is going to. Thank you for listening. I'll see you at 6 p.m. I'm going to do a Facebook Live, so make sure you're online and near my page. Hopefully that's early enough that it doesn't interrupt your New Year's celebrations. One last time, Happy New Year, my friends, and I'll talk to you soon. I'll see you at 6 p.m. Bye-bye.